Protons really offer a unique opportunity to deliver radiation in a way that minimizes the exposure of normal tissues to radiation. We have been developing the technology since the day we started this. So the technology today is very different than when it was 7 years ago when we opened the center. We've moved to something called pencil beam scanning, where we can take a 3-millimeter pencil beam and basically tattoo a tumor, where we really couldn't do that before. So putting a dose exactly where we want it while sparing those normal tissues allows us to do very unique things, and combining outside of radiation with chemotherapy, with biologic agents, with surgery, in much better ways that we could even when we started with the protons 7 years ago. This center, the Roberts Proton Therapy Center, was built in a very integrated way. It was built integrated with conventional radiation therapy, but it was also integrated with medical oncology, surgical oncology, all services. So the patient has everything in one center, and that's very unique across the spectrum of proton therapy. At the same time, you know, experience for patients is evolving and our expectation for experience is evolving. So we've done a lot of things in the Roberts Proton Therapy Center to change that experience. For instance, we've brought pet therapy in. We've brought complementary medical therapies into the center, so like Reiki therapy and acupuncture and massage and a variety of things that we're integrating into our waiting room experience. I think it's really important, you know, we're high tech, but we have to be high touch too. We have to be able to integrate these things together and think about the holistic experience for patients coming through the center.
I came to the Proton Therapy Center for radiation as a follow-up to chemo for my cancer. And so I had radiation for 6 weeks every day. And then when it finished and chemo finished, I sort of felt like I was no longer connected to the hospital. I was like, what do I do now? But then I learned about the alumni group and the meetings and then the proton pairs. And that gave me a way to stay connected with people in a similar situation and to the people that I had met at Penn. It just helps knowing that you're not alone. You know, I have a wonderful support system in my husband and my family, my children and friends, but it's nothing can take the place of just another person that's been laying on the table and having the radiation and just, you know, the doctor visits and the, you know, the whole process.
The reason I enjoy coming back to not just the weekly alumni gatherings, but primarily coming to the alumni annual, is to see how many people have survived and how many people can take advantage of what's available at Penn.
I will say the center is continuously under development. I'm really thrilled that Penn has committed to maintaining this center as the leading proton center in the world. So we've partnered with the vendors, we've partnered with development specialists to make sure our team is really stays at the cutting edge and our patients are getting the most cutting edge proton therapy there is.